Good morning and welcome to this special edition of the Rush Hour. My name is Darren Bartlett and today we continue the conversation on yoga. I know that we've been having, you know, a few people who are beneficiaries here and there, but the most important thing is for you to understand the background of yoga, its success and where it's going. Now, today we have the Minister of State, Microfinance and Small Enterprises, Honorable Haruna Kasolo Cheyune, who is going to be taking us through this journey of yoga. Good morning, Honorable. How are you today?
Fine, thank you. How are you? And good morning, viewers. I'm so happy for having been invited to articulate issues concerning yoga and the other other programs,
where than the your creation. Some time on up and, it's been a long journey to find you, but finally,
it's nice.
We have you here. Honorable, just to go maybe directly to our subject, yoga.
Yes.
First of all, what is yoga? It's not even an English word. So what is this yoga thing?
You see, yoga is a Western phenomenon. That means the coming together of people who are into the same enterprise. Say borders. If they are all border circles, they come together, they serve together, they do business together. That's omoga for border. If it is tax, so there is no mixture. If you are a journalist, you don't join tax operator circle. Yes, you don't join tax operator circle. So once it is done, then it ceases to be omoga.
Okay.
So omoga, that's the interpretation I can give. Yes, you are into the same enterprise, same skill. You come together for a common objective.
Okay, now since the launch of yoga, what would be your measurement of success in it? Has it succeeded or has it, or your towards success, or has it even failed?
No. To a great extent, it has succeeded. Because, you see, the main objective here was to create cheap credit for the people. We're encouraging people to do business. But people were giving reasons like we don't have capital. Where should we go for capital? Banks are there, but we don't have collateral security. So now we encourage them to join hands, start, saving together. And then government gives them a helping hand. Their savings are now supplemented by support from government every financial year. So their capital grows. And then this capital is supposed to devolve within the group. So members are loaned. So they get credit, cheap credit from within the circle without collateral and as cheap as at 8%. And because they have the same problems, they don't, even the recoveries becomes easier because they are from within the same locality, they are doing the same enterprise, therefore it is much easier for them to coordinate themselves and their activities.
Honorable, you talk about different groups. You've talked about drivers, that's like different enterprises.
Yes.
Like drivers, owners, probably farmers.
Farmers are not within the yoga. They are not within. These are the people that earn money every day. They are, especially the artisans. We are talking about the carpenters. We are talking about the tailors. We are talking about the welders. We are talking about bring on board the restaurant owners, the market vendors, the tax operators, the border circles, then the women entrepreneurs, and the youth leaders, then the...
One would want to think, why not farmers?
No, you see.
And they're doing something together. They feel like if we come
together, because we didn't have enough resources. And we never wanted it to scatter around. Because you see, once you don't have enough resources, and you scatter these scarce resources, then it means that you are going to end up being nowhere. Because you may wish to be everywhere, then you end up being nowhere. So we wanted to concentrate on the 18 categories first. So once these 18 categories have now excelled, then we can go for other categories. But now, the farmers you are talking about, yeah, we have given them a full program. This PDM is aimed at helping farmers. Those farmers, the agro-processors, those are we who are into value addition, this is their program. So we want to balance, the boat. But this MIOGA is for those categories that are into business that earns them money every day. Those people that earn money daily, these are the people that want it first help so that they upgrade.
Well, don't you think people or the citizens of Uganda would think that this is probably exclusive to a certain class of people? Because if I have an idea, as Darren, and Haruna also has, probably me and Haruna share the same idea of going to trade, probably in China. But what we want is to form together our money, come to government, pump us up, and then we go and get this product. Don't you think you've left out people with ideas and concentrated on people who are just looking at everyday money?
No, no. You see, government has so many programs. The problem with some people, they don't invest time in finding out what programs government has. There are so many. If it is food, we have buffet. We have PDM for the 39%. Those who are into subsistence, they work for stomach. We have a MIOGA. This MIOGA program is for those 18 categories that at least earn money. They are in between there. They earn money every day. Then there are those that have started business, but they want to expand their business. They lack capital. We have put money in different financial institutions, which is cheap money at 8%, maximum 10%. Then you interest them in going for that money so that they can expand their businesses.
What has been the uptake so far? And if there are any challenges, what are you doing to close those challenges in the uptake of the program?
You see, across the country? You see, poverty has been with us for so many years. Mm-hmm. I cannot lie to you. that we can fight poverty within 2, 3, 4, 5 years. So it has to be a continuous struggle. And it has to be, combined efforts. So there are challenges. You see, government has had so many interventions in the past. And some of these interventions have not excelled. And now we are bringing on board these new interventions, but of course, basing on the challenges that really were encountered when implementing the past programs, so that we don't repeat the same. So now we are bringing on board all key stakeholders. We are sensitizing people. We evaluate, we monitor every now and then. We have district task forces in every district, headed by the RDCs and the other elected leaders from their respective of their political differences. You see, those past programs found us at 68% subsistence, people working for stomach only, okay? Mm. But because of the interventions, these programs, we are now at 39%. So we are not 100% condemning the past programs. But now, these new programs, okay, well thought out programs, the MIOGA, the PDM, and the other programs, we want now to make sure that we shift from 39% subsistence to zero. So that now we are in the middle income, not even lower, upper. Upper middle income. So we want to make sure that at least people, every Ugandan, is actively involved in the economic activities. Every day, that daily income generating activities, every day. We don't want to see Ugandans who are spectators. When you are talking about issues of money, for them, they that is not none of our business. For us, we are not for money. Mm. It is for some other categories of people. No, we want all Ugandans to be financially included. Yes, all Ugandans must be actively involved in income generating activities. So that's why we are creating avenues where our people can go and have access to cheap credit. Number two, these programs, in fact, are going to help us indirectly. You see, these are the big financial institutions, okay? They charge exorbitant interest rate, 24, 30, because, you know, the demand for their monies is high. And money, like any other commodities, once the demand is high, definitely they must raise the interest. So once now we mobilize Ugandans into groups, into saving groups, they have their circles, the government supports them, the demand for those monies will have to come down. And therefore they will hold the crisis meetings and ask themselves why now,
and they reduce the interest rate.
They definitely reduce this because the demand will have reduced. Yes. So I'm trying to mobilize my people, but in so doing, I want to force those people, those giants, to reduce the interest rate. Because we have asked them and they tend not to listen. Mm-hmm. Because there is no way Ugandans can do business and enjoy profits when they got expensive credit as capital. Yes. So we want people to go to their groups, circles, Mioga circles, get credit, finance your business, then get returns, pay back, like that. So that now all Ugandans are happy enjoying their businesses.
Again, just to connect back to that, I know that you're trying to, you know, mobilize Ugandans to get into Mioga, okay? But where you have received low uptake, what is the reason behind it? For example, if I say maybe Karamoja, there's low
uptake,
what could be the reason why people are not...
For Karamoja, you see the timing. This program, the success of this program, to some extent, was hindered by COVID and politics. COVID and politics. Because this program came at a time when all people, the anxiety now was on politics. They were all talking about politics. Even when I was on TV, on radio, popularizing the program, others could just call in to abuse me, thinking that we are trying to corrupt them, to vote for NRM. Mm-hmm. So that hindered, to a large extent, the success of the program. And then COVID. Because remember, COVID restrictions, we couldn't hold many meetings, big meetings, rallies and what have you. So in Uganda, why in Uganda here, I can say Uganda has performed better because I mobilized the beneficiaries in Uganda before COVID. But Karamoja, by the time I went to Karamoja, I was restricted. I could just meet few people. And you see now few people going back, you can never tell whether they would disseminate the same information without changing it, the same message. So now I am going back. I have already visited the central region. I have already gone to Greta Ankole, Greta Chigezi, Rwenzori. Now I'm in Busoga. Mm. So it is not that people are against the program, but maybe they were not mobilized well. Yeah, they were not mobilized the way. And that's the reason why I'm bringing all leaders on board. Because you see, different leaders have different supporters. When I go to Karamoja, even if I'm minister for microfinance, people might not listen to me. But they have interest, they have confidence in their leaders, the MPs. That's why I must move with them. so that when I leave Karamoja, now it is them to continue mobilizing.
Actually, now that you bring up that point, one of the challenges that came out, or issues that came out in some of the programs like youth livelihood and things like that, now in Yoga, is that people lack financial literacy. And what are you doing as a ministry to see that people get, they get better financial training, so that when they get in these programs, they success out of it?
You see, even by you inviting me for this program, we are supporting financial literacy. These are the we are supposed to continue preaching and the work to continue working on people's mindset. People are addicted to getting free things from government, and they don't have that element of ownership. Whatever government gives to people, they think it should be abused, it should be eaten, it should be spoiled. Okay, so now we are sensitizing them every now and then. We are using different approaches. This program should not fail, because now we know that past programs failed maybe because they didn't do A, B, C, D. And now with this program, we must do all. We must dip all approaches. Yes, all approaches. So we must continue sensitizing. And we have teams on the ground. In every district, we have teams. We have TOTs. We have people from the local people. We have selected the trainers from within the localities. And they are using their local languages, taking people through, the program, the do's and the don'ts. And I think this program must succeed.
It must succeed.
It is, yes, because you see now, as we speak now, we have realized 74 billion shillings savings. Cut us off a Miyoga. So that means that this program has mobilized, has persuaded, has interested people in saving. Now, they have this money, it is their money. Without a Miyoga, it would be in their stomach. But now they have it.
All right, Honorable, I know we have less time to go, but maybe your final words, you could just tell us, or the viewers, where they can go to find more information on Miyoga and how they sign up.
Very good, thank you. We have district task force. In every district, we have a team that spearheads the implementation of Miyoga, headed by the RDC. And the members are elected as LOC5 MPs, commercial officer, COW. So, our viewers, if you cannot reach out to me, go to your district, visit the RDC, ask him all questions concerning Miyoga. He has the answers. So if he's not useful, then I can give you my contact. You send me a SMS or WhatsApp, it is 0775-845164. If you are not helped at the district, then you can reach out to me.
Thank you so much, Honorable Haruna Cheyune Kasolo, for sparing some time to be with us here and talk about the Miyoga. For now, I would say the program has come to an end, and I would want to wish you a lovely day. See you tomorrow.